Agor a lagaid fy nghalon, agor fy llagaid y nawr, rwyf am dy weld i, rwyf am dy weld i. Agor a lagaid fy nghalon, agor fy llagaid y nawr, rwyf am dy weld i. Rwyf am dy weld i. I'th weld yn farch a fedig frim, disgleirion olein i dogoniant. Tawallt y gariad at nerth, fe ganw'n sanctaidd, sanctaidd, sanctaidd. Agor y lagaid fy nghalon, agor fy llagaid y nawr, rwyf am dy weld i, rwyf am dy weld i. Agor y lagaid fy nghalon, agor fy llagaid y nawr, rwyf am dy weld i. Rwyf am dy weld i. I'th weld yn farch a fedig frim, disgleirion olein i dogoniant. Tawallt y gariad ar nerth, fe ganw'n sanctaidd, sanctaidd, sanctaidd.
Sanctai, Sanctai, Sanctai. Sanctai, Sanctai, Sanctai. Sanctai, Sanctai, Sanctai. Rui vanto valdi. Sanctai, Sanctai, Sanctai. Sanctai, Sanctai, Sanctai. Sanctai, Sanctai, Sanctai. Rui vanto valdi.
Ffrindiau croeso. Dear friends, welcome. In the commercial world, today is Valentine's Day. Did you receive a bouquet of flowers? Or even a single rose? Or did you receive a hand-painted card from the special little person in your life, given with unconditional love? Or as in our daily life, all we need is a look, a touch, a word, to show that you are loved. All these can be wow moments. In the church calendar, today is Transfiguration Sunday, when Peter, James and John went up a mountain with Jesus, and he was transfigured before them. And there also appeared Elijah and Moses talking to Jesus. For the disciples, this must have been a very frightening moment, but also a wow moment. This Sunday prepares us for our Lenten journey towards the cross and the empty tomb. On this special day, let us think of our school, St. Aidan's. Think of our teachers, support staff, children and their families, and help and support them for when normal days arrive again. So whether we are in the grandest cathedral, or as we are today in our homes, sitting in an armchair with our coffee, and possibly wearing our slippers, the message is the same. Our Heavenly Father loves and cares for us. So let us continue our journey together with our service of praise. We gather. People of God, raise your expectations of what it means to encounter God in this place. Be open to God revealing something of his divine nature to us and changing the way we see the world. Almighty God, we ask you to show us something more of who you are and how awesome your presence is. Overcome our fear of the unknown and lead us into a new experience of you. May our worship today be as on a mountaintop, a transforming encounter that empowers our discipleship. Amen. Lord Jesus, you can make ordinary things special. You can surprise us when we least expect it, and you can make us see things differently because you are amazing. Amen.
Sing of the Lord's goodness, Father of all wisdom, come to him and bless his name. Mercy he has shown us, his love is forever, faithful to the end of days. Come then, all you nations, sing of your Lord's goodness, melodies of praise and thanks to God. Ring out the Lord's glory, praise him with your music, worship him and bless his from the snares of death. His word he has spoken, one bread he has broken, new life he now gives to all. Come then, all you nations, sing of your Lord's goodness, melodies of praise and thanks to God. Bring out the Lord's glory, praise him with your music, worship him and bless his name. In our darkness, comfort in our sorrow, Spirit of our God Most High. Solace for the weary, pardon for the sinner, splendor of the living God. Come then, all you nations, sing of your Lord's goodness, melodies of praise and thanks to God. And bring out the Lord's glory, praise him with your music, worship him and
Elijah taken up to heaven. When the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven in a whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here, the Lord has sent me to Bethel." But Elisha said, "As surely as the Lord lives and as you live, I will not leave you." So they went down to Bethel. The company of the prophets at Bethel came out to Elisha and asked, Do you know that the Lord is going to take your master from you today? Yes, I know, Elisha replied, so be quiet. Then Elijah said to him, Stay here, Elisha. The Lord has sent me to Jericho. And he replied, As surely as the Lord lives and as you live, I will not leave you. So they went to Jericho. The company of the prophets at Jericho went up to Elisha and asked him, Do you know that the Lord is going to take your master from you today? Yes, I know, he replied, so be quiet. Then Elijah said to him, Stay here, the Lord has sent me to the Jordan. And he replied, As surely as the Lord lives and as you live, I will not leave you. So the two of them walked on. 50 men from the company of the prophets went and stood at a distance, facing the place where Elijah and Elisha had stopped at the Jordan. Elijah took his cloak, rolled it up, and struck the water with it. The water divided to the right and to the left, and the two of them crossed over on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, Tell me, what can I do for you before I am taken from you? Let me inherit a double portion of your spirit, Elisha replied. You have asked a difficult thing, Elijah said. Yet if you see me when I am taken from you, it will be yours, otherwise it will not. As they were walking along and talking together, suddenly a chariot of fire and horses of fire appeared and separated the two of them. And Elijah went up to heaven in a whirlwind. Elisha saw this and cried out, my father, the chariots and horsemen of Israel. And Elisha saw him no more. Then he took hold of his garment and tore it in two. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Shattering others, walls made of living stone. The second reading is the Gospel. Listen to the Gospel of Christ according to St. Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. 6 days later, Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no one on earth could bleach them. And there appeared to them Elijah with Moses, who were talking with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus, Rabbi, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. He did not know what to say, for they were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud there came a voice. This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him. Suddenly, when they looked around, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one about what they had seen, until after the Son of Man had risen from the dead. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Morning, everyone. I'm just going to show you a picture. I've got some visual aids today, and I hope you won't mind me showing them. But this is, I hope you can see it, this is the Mount of Transfiguration, or as is known, Mount Tabor. Forgive me if I've got the shakes. This is on the mountain where the disciples, Peter, James and John, met Jesus with Elijah and Moses, and you'll recall the story of Peter desperately trying to make shelters, or offering to make shelters for them. Well, he didn't succeed in doing that, but our later fellow Christians certainly achieved it. I hope you can see that. That's the chapel, or the Basilica of the Transfiguration, on the top of Mount Tabor. Now, when Bishop Wynne and I led a pilgrimage to the Holy Land, we ended up going up Mount Tabor with the party. And when we got up there, it was foggy. So foggy, we could not see a thing, hardly in front of us. There we were with our cameras to take the view, and there was nothing there. And I remember Bishop Wynne saying at the time, when we were stood by the rails looking out towards the fog, that he said there might be wisdom, that there is something to be seen when one can't see anything. There's something to be seen when one can't see anything. How we laughed when he said that. And today I think I'm thinking about Peter. Well, I know I'm thinking about Peter having the in the manner of a dad's army moment when I think he perhaps begins to panic a little bit, instead of standing still and taking in that which was right in front of him, in all that brilliant light and incomprehensible mystery. He starts scrambling around, searching for little bits of this and that to build some shelters for the holy ones who stood before him. Perhaps Peter was grasping for control over something that he couldn't control. And we're all a bit like that, aren't we? Yeah, I guess we are. But yes, I do see myself a little bit in him today. And as we're not able to do what we've always done, and just occasionally that bit of Captain Mannering moment, panic, what shall I do now, comes in. So, I wonder what we shall do when we get back to normal, everybody says. What shall we do when we get back to normal? Now, for me, being a tactile kind of person, those of you who know me well will know that, And in fact, I'm always very sinful, even now. Even with my mask, I kind of go towards people and invade their personal space. But there we are. I'm tactile, and I like to visit, and I like to hug, and I like to sit with people, and I like to listen with them. I like to sing with them as well. And so that's quite hard, isn't it? But we shall be mistaken into thinking that because we can't be with somebody, that there is little help there for them, because there's all sorts of stuff that we can do, which we have been doing. But, you know, we might even be tempted to think that because we aren't there, God isn't. But actually, God is everywhere, just as he was with Peter, and he is much there or here. As he always is. And someone has said that, as individuals, we sometimes think that we're the centre of the universe, and that, only stuff can happen when we're around. Of course, that's quite wrong, isn't it? So, I've been thinking, in this time of if this story is trying to teach me something more deeply, to rely on the truth that God is acting even when I can't yet see it, or I am merely witnessing to the good that God does and will do. And as Peter was scrambling around for materials to make shelters, and so almost missing the moment, perhaps I need to release my control button. Perhaps I need to release my control button, and I believe that we can be surprised and astonished by how the tears of the present have allowed life to emerge out of this time of restriction. Things that seem so dead once are yielding shades of green. And on this Valentine's Day, one of the signs of Valentine's Day is in mid-February, where we see lots of mating pairs rushing around, nesting. Yes, spring is almost upon us. And as you have heard now through my talk and my rambling and perhaps little bits of stuttering, I'm still, as you, trying to work all this out, all this time that we have been in present restrictions. But Peter worked it out eventually, and perhaps we will work something out too. What I'm wondering is how these momentous events of the last months will change not only how we shall serve each other, but how we shall live. That is, when we can more easily be and do as we were accustomed to being and doing. And in these moments, even if it seems foggy, like it was with me and Bishop Wynne, I think it will be good to do what God asks of us in our gospel reading, to listen to him, to listen to Jesus, to listen to our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ, because, you know, he is with us even in our own little shelters. Now, I'm going to read a prayer to you from my prayer book, which my mother gave me in 1966 on the occasion of my confirmation. I think it's a favourite prayer of mine, not often used in our services these days. And it goes like this: Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And so let Christ's light shine in you today. And I have a song to sing you, which was sung in the fog on the Mount of Transfiguration. So I'll go and get my guitar and we'll do that soon. God bless.
Joy that seeketh me through pain, I cannot close my heart to thee. I trace the rainbow through the rain, and I feel the promise is not vain, that morn shall tell us be. That will not let me go. I rest my weary soul in thee. I give thee back the life I hold, that in thine ocean depths explore, may richer fall be.
The peace. Christ will transfigure our human body and give it a form like that of his own glorious body. We are the body of Christ. We share his peace. The peace of the Lord be with us always, and also with you.
Peace be with you, everyone.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you, Mum.
Simon.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you all.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
And peace be with you always.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you, Pearl.
Peace be with you, McKay.
Peace be with you all.
I never do. A fo gyda chi oll byth bythoedd.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you, Mum, and peace with you, Lady.
The peace of the Lord be with us always.
And also with you.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We close our eyes and imagine. We open our eyes and see. We close our eyes to see visions. We open our eyes to find others. We close our eyes and dream dreams. We open our eyes and look for Jesus. Eyes closed, eyes open. Lord Jesus, may we always see you. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Almighty God, we ask you to show us something more of who we are and how awesome your presence is. Overcome our fear with the unknown and lead us into new experiences of you. Our worship today is of the mountaintop, transforming that powers our discipleship. Lord, in our mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Jesus' divine nature was confirmed on the mountain. He is our God's beloved Son. He went to suffer. He died and rose again, conquering sin and death. Now he sits at God's right hand, glorified in heaven. And thank him, we are completely forgiven. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Strengthen Joanna, our bishop, and all our church in the service of Christ. May those who confess your name be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Bless and guide Elizabeth, our Queen. Give wisdom to all in authority. Direct this and every nation in the maze of justice and of peace. May we honour one another and seek the common good. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Bless the work of the Mothers' Union throughout the world, and particularly our own branch here in Wissen, as Margaret Evans, our leader. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who are suffering body, mind and spirit. Give them courage and hope, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Give to us, our families and friends, and all our neighbours. We serve Christ in one another and love as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Hear us as we remember those who have died in the faith of Christ. According to your promises, grant them a share in your eternal kingdom. We remember with sadness Peter Voyle of Wissen. Peter, 87 years old, was a wonderful butcher in Clubston Road. As the cortege left the village, the neighbours and friends of Oakland Terrace came out to say goodbye to Peter, who was cremated. Our prayers go out to Roger, Beryl and Steph, and all the family in their sadness. May Peter rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
May the cross of Christ give you hope. May the cross of Christ give you joy. May the cross of Christ give you confidence. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy at this time of uncertainty and distress. Sustain and support the anxious and fearful, and lift all those who are brought low, that we may rejoice in the comfort that knowing nothing can separate us from your love in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Holy God, as we remember those who are working to keep things going, those working in the NHS, and those around helping to keep things working, those keeping our streets clean and collecting our rubbish, those harvesting, delivering and selling food in our shops, and the postmen who deliver our mail. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, thank you for this time together. Whatever happens this week, help us to go on following you in our faith and keep our roots firmly planted in you. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
And finally, we pray for ourselves and for all the many blessings we have received at God's hand. May we always be grateful and never forget to say thank you to our Lord Jesus. Give us courage and hope for the future of our churches. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
And a prayer to my family. Come, Holy Spirit, fill my heart with peace. Come, Holy Spirit, fill my heart with love. Come, Holy Spirit, fill my life with your power. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
And two prayers that are close to my heart. Teach us, good Lord, to serve thee as thou deservest, to give and not to count the cost, to fight and not to heed the wound, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labour and not to ask for any reward except of knowing that we do thy will. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
And a prayer for St. Francis of Assisi. Make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me so love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Merciful Lord, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Jesus shall take the highest honour. Jesus shall take the highest praise. Let all earth join heaven in exalting the name which is above all other names. Let's bow the knee in humble adoration, for at his name every knee must bow. Let every tongue confess he is Christ, God's only Son. Sovereign Lord, we give you
We give thanks. On a mountain top with Jesus, the disciples were in awe. They just could not believe it, what they heard and saw. Help us, Lord, to see you today, just as they did in that special way. Amen. Life before you, Jesus, was empty, void. But wow, what a difference your presence makes. We are so grateful for the day we tuned into the good news. What a wonder it is that the light seen by the disciples on the mountain can be seen shining in us today. Thank you, Lord, for your transforming power. Amen. For such great love, we give you thanks with the angels and saints as they praise you and say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
On a mountaintop with Jesus, the disciples were in awe. They just could not believe it, what they heard and saw. Help us, Lord, to see you today, just as they did in that special way. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Ein tad yr hwn oeden yn nefoedd, sancteiddi'r denw, deled y dernas, gwneler dywyllus, megis yn y nef, felly ar y ddeiar hefyd. Dyrwy ni heddiw ein barab ein yddiol, a maddau ni ein dyledion, fel myddau yw ninnau i dyledwyr. Ac nac arwain ni brofedigaeth, aeth i'r gwared ni rhag drwg, cynnes iddo ti yw'r dernas, a'r gallu, a'r gogoniant. Yn oes oesoedd. Amen.
Brenin y brenhin oedd yw diolch, halleluja. Arglwydd yr arglwyddi yw diolch, halleluja. Iesu twysog hedd diolch, halleluja. Iesu twysog hedd diolch, halleluja. Brenin y brenhin oedd yw diolch, halleluja. Arglwydd yr arglwyddi yw diolch, halleluja. Iesu twysog hedd diolch, halleluja. Iesu twysog hedd diolch, halleluja. Brenin y brenhin oedd yw diolch, halleluja. Arglwydd yr arglwyddi yw diolch, halleluja. Iesu twysog hedd diolch, halleluja. Iesu twysog hedd diolch, halleluja. Brenin y brenhin oedd yw diolch, halleluja. Arglwydd yr arglwyddi yw diolch, halleluja. Iesu twysog hedd diolch, halleluja. Iesu twysog hedd diolch, halleluja. Brenin y brenhin oedd yw diolch, halleluja. Arglwydd yr arglwyddi yw diolch, halleluja. Iesu twysog hedd diolch, halleluja. Iesu twysog hedd diolch, halleluja.
We go out. As we go back down the mountain, God, we bring to you those who need a wow moment in their life. Those who had lost hope, those who have little money, those who live in places of violence, those who don't feel loved. Surprise and bless them. In Jesus' name, Amen. Lord Jesus, raise our expectations of what it means to encounter God, not just in this place, but in every place. In all the places we shall be in the days ahead. Help us every day to discover something new about God's ways, about what God wants of us, and change the way we see the world and the way we act. Amen.
Tang nefydd Dyw sydd i'w chlaw pob deall, a gadw eich calonau a'ch meddyliau yng ngwybodaeth a chariad Dyw. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you, remain with you and those you love wherever they may be, this day and always. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.
Oh, Here's a song for Valentine's Day. It's even got a biblical reference in it.
Such wonderful things to you if you were the only girl.